Good morning, folks. It is Monday morning. It is the 7th of December. It is a bright and crisp morning outside. It's lovely to be able to see the sunshine again, even though it is, that'll be a bit cooler. But I wonder what sort of weekend that you've had. Has it been a quiet one? Has it been a restful one? Or has it been a difficult one? For all of us, things are different. But it's good that we can do this, that we can come together, that we can read God's word and see what it says to us. So this morning we're going to be starting into 2 Thessalonians. There's only three chapters in this book, so we'll be doing that Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and then we'll do something different for Thursday and Friday. So let's hear 2 Thessalonians together. This letter is from Paul, Silas and Timothy. We are writing to the church in Thessalonica, to you who belong to God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. May God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ give you grace and peace. Dear brothers and sisters, we can't help but thank God for you, because your faith is flourishing and your love for one another is growing. We proudly tell God's other churches about your endurance and faithfulness in all the persecutions and hardships you are suffering. And God will use this persecution to show his justice and to make you worthy of his kingdom, for which you are suffering. In his justice, he will pay back those who persecute you. And God will provide rest for you who are being persecuted, and also for us when the Lord Jesus appears in heaven from heaven. He will come with his mighty angels in flaming fire, bringing judgment on those who don't know God and on those who refuse to obey the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ. They will be punished with eternal destruction, forever separated from the Lord and from his glorious power. When he comes on that day, he will receive glory from his people, praise from all who believe. And this includes you, for you believe what you were told about him. So we keep on praying for you, asking our God to enable you to live a life worthy of his call. May he give you the power to accomplish all the good things your faith promotes you to do. In the name of our Lord Jesus, we'll be honoured because of the way you live, and you will be honoured along with him. All this is made possible because of the grace of our God and Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. It continues on the theme towards the end of 1 Thessalonians, whenever Paul, and as he was writing, talked about how we are not separated in death, how we'll be reunited, talking again about how Christ would come, but this time with a bit of a warning as well. Paul talks about the judgment that will come on those who don't believe. You know, that's not a very nice thing to sort of think about. It's something which a lot of people don't talk about. You know, don't talk about judgment and don't talk about punishment. And God is a God of love, but God is a God of justice. So as well as there being the reward for following him, there's also the punishment upon those who don't follow him. But in this letter as well, at the start, there's quite an emphasis on prayer and on praying for one another and remembering one another. At the very start, verse 3, we can't help but thank God for you because your faith is flourishing and your love for one another is growing. And down to verse 11 again, so we keep on praying for you. You know, we quite often say to one another, I'll be praying for you. But I wonder, do we really? Do we take that time, or do we just say that to somebody in passing because we think it's something that they want to hear? We are encouraged to pray for one another. Prayer is powerful. Prayer is our communication, our chat with God. It's our way of pouring out to him what we're feeling. And yes, God knows what we're feeling. God knows our thoughts. And it's easy to say, I'll pray for you. And then just leave that and say, oh, God's heard that. So, you know, that's that prayer done. But it's not actually take time and pray. Actually set aside time whenever you can. Thank God for things that are happening. Praise him for the wonderful things that are in your life, but then bring to him the things that are either troubling you or a friend. This letter talks about the persecution and how the persecution will be used for God's glory. But think about friends who are suffering. Think about friends who are having a hard time, or those that you know, and name them before God, and he will remember them. Our God is a faithful God who does wonderful things for us. The best thing that he does for us is grace. And that last verse, then the name of our Lord Jesus will be honoured because of the way you live, and you'll be honoured along with him. All of this made possible because of the grace of our God and Lord Jesus Christ. God's grace is what changes everything. It transforms our lives. It can transform this world whenever we just let his grace in. So today, whether you've already done it or not, just let his grace into your life. Let it flow through you. Let him direct you and guide you, and just see what he can do with you this day. Thanks, folks, for listening. Let's just pray together. Lord and Heavenly Father, we just again thank you for another glorious day. Another day which has been given to us by you. Another day we can live our lives centered and focused upon you. Live our lives in such a way that the actions of our lives point others to you. That we can show love to one another, love to those around us, and especially love to those who are unloved and the outcasts of society. Lord, just show us those opportunities to be able to do that, so that in doing so, we will show people your love and your grace. Lord, you're a great and a faithful God. So in everything that we have happening today, we ask for your strength, your leading, your direction. May you be with us. May you surround us with your arms and keep us safe. And may we bring that flavour of your love to all that we do. So Father, thank you. In Christ's name, amen. Thanks, folks, for joining with me this morning. I'll see you again same time tomorrow morning. Take care. God bless. Bye.